well, Letterman thing, but.
Oh, he said he didn't give a shit who's doing his show.
Yeah, we got.
And they give it to a woman. Maybe he's not a Colbert fan, or maybe he just doesn't give a fuck.
I don't think so. Play that video. There's a video of him.
Tom Brokaw. I guess
he did an interview with Tom Brokaw. And he said he doesn't care. He's glad he's done with it. It right. was, I guess it was that many years. That's a lot of fucking pressure and stress.
20,
long
30.
Fuck, yeah, long time. And he said he kind of acknowledged that it fucked up other aspects of his life. Putting that much energy and that much of your life into it. But, you know, I'm sure he's enjoying what he made while he was doing that.
Yeah, and his kid's like, you know, 8 or 9 now, so he's fine. You know, he could spend time
with soccer games, Pizza Friday.
Yeah, whatever he's got. Yeah.
All that shit.
Doing all that shit. You know
all that shit.
He fucked a hot chick for like 30 years, and he's like, go ahead, somebody else fuck her. I'm done.
Yeah, yeah, that's pretty much what it is.
Had her in her prime.
Yeah, that's a great example, because Tom Brokaw at some point asked, like, has CBS called you on and asked any advice on Colbert's show? And it's like, how would you do that? Like, so how do you fuck this girl to really satisfy her? Yeah,
don't dance like a fucking moron during every monologue.
Yeah, I've made that call.
What's going on with these late-night shows?
They love doing a little dance. And a little, yeah, because it's safe and fun for everybody.
I love a good dance.
You like when the host dances with everybody?
Lightens the mood.
Reminds me of Ellen. I just enjoy it.
Let's see David Letterman in his little interview. Look at him. He just doesn't give a shit.
He's so Jim Gaffigan's father.
And then the first day of Stephen's show,
when
he went on the air, an energy left me, and I felt like, you know, that's not my problem anymore. And I've kind of felt that way ever since. I devoted so much time to the damage of other aspects of my life, concentrated, fixated, focusing on that. It's good now to not have that. I couldn't care less about late night television. I'm happy for the guys, men and women. There should be more women. And I don't know why they didn't give my show to a woman. That would have been fine. You know, I'm happy for their success, and they're doing things I couldn't do, so that's great.
Did they ask you about who should replace you?
No, they didn't ask me about anything. They were just happy I was going.
Happy he was going.
Yeah. I do a good Letterman.
Yeah, let me see.
Yeah. Paul Schaefer. That good?
That's pretty good. I know who you were.
Thank you.
Gonna
complimented your.
It did. Okay. My Tom Brokaw.
That's the look with all those late night guys when they're off. Remember Conan was off for a while. He had the beard.
Yeah.
Bear had the beard.
They
grow the big beard.
Beard. And
it's the look.
I don't know what it is.
I like when they do the karaoke in the car.
Oh, car karaoke. It's so cute. I'm fucking done with
that. I enjoyed that when Harry Chapin did it. Topical reference, 1981.
He said,
"Going, he was singing, going out of my head over you." I think.
We're gonna just die in a taxi. Boo,
a boo.
I never seen car karaoke.
Oh, good, Adele.
I feel like Americans are gonna get to assume that England is rubbish.
No, not when this puppy comes
out. Hello. Can you hear
us? I don't know.
He's the guy.
Steve.
Oh, he's the
James Corden.
Isn't he late? He's a late night fucking
on Corazon.
He does a chat show.
Corazon.
Whatever. I don't know the guy's name. Says
what? Right enough. I can't fucking even take this anymore.
Ross the intern.
I can't.
Turn it off.
No, I can't.
I like this. It's good natured.
People love it.
Lighthearted.
They just keep feeding people stuff like this, and they just sit and eat it up, and the world crumbles around them.
We're so quick fix now and moving. It's like the idea of just interviewing somebody anymore, it's not interesting. And celebrities don't hold any power anymore, or much power, as far as, ooh, there's Marlon Brando. Because we see them every day doing different real-life shit.
So we want more out of them than just an interview.
We don't give a fuck. There's nothing special about watching Johnny Depp talk because of what's been happening. I'd love to hear him talk.
What happened? I didn't hear.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Like that.
I'm going to Florida soon.
Yeah. Yeah, he'll be going to
Florida.
I have
the same room.
The Artie Lang suite.
Yeah.
Johnny, whack your bag before you go.
Yeah. Jack off before you go, Johnny.
That's when you want to hear a celebrity when they're in trouble. Well, aside from that, no one gives a fuck how fun your project was.
No one cares.
It's terrible.
That's there used to be a mystique now.
Yeah, and that's why there's no buzz about late night TV unless a goofy video like this goes on.
Yeah.
Nobody cares that.
But no one's watching it live.
Tom
they
Cruise,
watch it online the
right,
next day.
No one cares about what's happening.
But that Tom Cruise is going on a Tonight Show. Like, there's no buzz there whatsoever. Nobody gives a shit. No one's talking about it the
to
next
be,
day.
People used to go, oh, I'm going to tune in and watch that.
Absolutely.
Now you don't even DVR it to watch it later. You just wait for the highlight clip. And if there is none, you just don't give a fuck anyway.
No.
Yeah, that's where we are.
I'm going to watch it on Snapchat.
Yeah.